one female, they grow on the same development class, and you are selling a group, you have like a specific topic, and you are talking about it. So when one person speaks one sentence, so the other will speak another, like, for example, if I'm speaking about breaking, so directly about football, some ideas will come to his mind, like this. So if you develop understanding, I'll talk about cricket, cheese and person and cricket too. He'll talk about bathing, you talk about bowling, like they. So it develop understanding, it develop many things.
It's basically collecting different opinions.
Yeah.
Our opinion may be different here, so then you develop a consensus on that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So what is the proof that students have developed consensus?
Sorry?
What's the proof in class that students have mutually developed understanding?
You
what's the proof of that?
That students are in class. They have understanding. What is the proof? The proof is that I'm speaking about, a particular thing. So they will agree that yes, that is.
So they agree
they
and
show
then
yeah.
They form a collective opinion, they come up with one
paper. And they will agree. They are
with one statement. But in opinions of everyone, so there are different parts in that. It means that they have developed consensus.
They have developed
shared their ideas.
That's
experiments, and what they have done in different activities, practical roles.
Yes, that's right. Okay, yes, what about this thing? Thank you. Okay. Yes. Yes. Okay, their question was that how we know that students are working in comfort zone, or trouble zone, or they are uncomfortable in the class. So it's good and it's best to work in comfort zone. And how it seems that they actually are respected but what they say, they are listened, and they are, whatever they say, whether it is right or wrong. They are not laughed at. So don't laugh at even if it is an idiotic, it's even an idiotic opinion. Don't laugh. So that's good. That how we can make students to work in comfortable zone, to tell them to work in groups, to listen to their opinion, and to value their opinion also.
Yes.
So,
if this is right or wrong, that's
very good. Yes, that's right. Okay. Yes, your answer was quite satisfactory. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Our question is on questioning what evidence is there that is being questioned towards the peers or towards the teacher. What we thought was that the student, like there could be two ways. One could be that the teacher could provide an open topic to the student, for example, write an essay about your school. And then what students could do is either they might specify, put specifically a topic to today's idea, the school is not bad, it's a very specific topic. What we could ask the students is to open topic discussion and you'll see what part of the discussion will they take. Will they go for teacher, will they go for students, or will they go for the classroom environment?
Mm-hmm.
And from that we know consensus later decide that it won't as a topic of the school, we decided to talk about the teachers tonight. The second what they could do is we could ask the students to each one of them, can you please tell is this your point or did you ask someone else about
yes,
it?
Yes, that's right. So ask them what their opinions and it shows that everyone has participated. Everyone has contributed.
I would like to add that the class environment, they have been asking us to prove as in are they active learners or something like that. The class environment will be proof of that. How active your learners are, how much feedback they give you, how many group activities you're having. So those all are proofs that you have an active. That they do collaborate with the teachers and students.
Okay, yes, very good. Everyone has given really, it seems that we have good exposure to teaching and definitely to all our learners also. But I think that your ideas, right, you have brainstormed on these questions. It means you all have participated and you all are active learners. And it proves that if I ask, for example, what's your opinion, so I know that she participated. I ask, okay, what's the you think, right? And so in this way, we know in the class that who is active, who is passive. And ask from other students also, if someone seems very non-responsive, some students don't take interest at all. So how you can make such students interested in the process of learning? By giving them responsibility, encouraging them also.
Yes.